And welcome to another Scriptcase tutorial. Today we're going to be looking at implementing a web chat system inside of Scriptcase. This hopefully will be very helpful to you if you have a customer-facing product that might need some sort of support for users to type in questions and for real-time support. So I hope this is helpful for you. It's very simple, very easy to do inside of Scriptcase. So I'm excited to share it with you. My name is Nate Carpenter. I'm a Scriptcase instructor. And so I'm going to be leading this tutorial. I hope it's helpful for you. Let's get started. So there are probably a few different products that you could look at to implement web chat inside of Scriptcase. But today we're going to be looking at Talk. That's T-A-W-K. And you can go there at talk.to. Right here, you can see it in my URL bar here. Easy URL to remember. And this system is very easy to implement in Scriptcase. So that's why we're going to be using it today. Really very little code. And you just kind of drop it in place and it works and it has a great back end. And we're actually going to be looking at that in a little bit, but let's look at what this final product will look like just so you can get an idea of what we're going for here. So I have open here, this is the Scriptcase e-learning demo system. So this is one of the demo systems that comes with your Scriptcase development environment. And I've just modified it very slightly to add in chatting. So as you can see here, I have my web chat window here, has a little message here, and I can type something in here like so. Okay, so it sent that message. And so that's basically what we're going for. We're going to be looking at building a little web chat system like this. And you've probably seen this at websites that you've used, so I hope this is helpful. So let's go back and look at Talk and see how to set this up. So we go to their homepage here. This is some of the different things that they offer, and you can just sign up for free right here. And as you can see, I'm already logged in here, but it would go through a sign up process. But I'm already logged in here. And once you log in, you see something like this. So we've got some monitoring data here, the number of chats, visitors, page views, etc. So you can kind of monitor that. And then if you go here, you got some more monitoring data, and these are monitoring individual messages here. So we've got a message coming in. That's the one we just saw there. And then if we click over here, we've got active chats. And as you can see, we have one incoming here. So let's click that. And look, there it says, hello, I need help. And so it's got my user in here. So let's click join here. And so now I've joined the chat. So let me reply. So now I'm a support person or an administrator trying to help one of the customers out. So I send that. And if I go back over here, the support person has sent this message. So now we can continue and help this customer out if we wanted to. So that's just kind of a quick demo of how that's done. Let's look at some of the other features that Talk gives us. So this is the support side. And this is where you would actually answer chats. And so your support people would watch this for incoming chats. If we go over here, we've got messaging, and this is to set up a ticket system. So if you wanted a ticket system to track different support chats and fixing issues, you could do that in this as well. So that's very useful. You could do some reporting here, some more monitoring of chats and things. Then there's also add-ons, just a few add-ons here. So you can hire actual agents for $1 an hour. You can remove some of the branding if that's what you want. Do some voice video sharing, and they've got some other features coming soon as well. And I should mention that all of this is completely free until you get to these add-ons. Everything here, you don't have to pay for. It's just simple chatting. So the add-ons here are the only things you need to pay for. So that's really cool. So we've got the add-ons, and now we want to go to settings here. So that's this little gear here. And the way it works with Talk is you set up a property. So that's like a website. So my website, if you see here, is anycarpenter.com. So I've already set up that property and I've named it Any Carpenter. And if I look at the property settings, you can do it right here. You can set up the site name, the URL, and then it generates a site ID, API key, forwarding email, all of that if you want to. And then there's a few other settings here. If you really wanted to dig deep into those, you could, but we're not going to look at them too much right now. Over here, we have some code, and that's how we're going to implement it in Scriptcase. But for now, Let's look at some of the other settings and then we'll look at how to implement this in Scriptcase. I just want to make sure that you have an understanding of everything Talk can do for you. So let's look at some of the appearance settings. So if we want to make this look a little bit different, maybe we don't want this to appear down here. Maybe we want to move it around. Maybe we want to change these colors because they don't really look good on our website. We can do that here in the widget appearance right here. So we click on that. Here we can make it different so it looks like this little blurb here down here at the bottom. We can make it look different for desktop or mobile settings. We can also display a little bubble that says something up like this. We can just control the content of that bubble. Turn that off. And we can also control where it appears on the page. So we could put it up in this corner, over here, down here, over there. Like that. So let's move it over here to the left. We're going to move it to this bubble. We're going to put a bubble right here. We're going to leave it to that, but let's change this color. Maybe let's make that black just because we want to. So it should look something like this now on our web page. So we've saved that. Let's go back and refresh this page and wait for it to load here. And there it is right down here. With our little message like that, we can open it up and here we are. So that's just a basic overview of some of what Talk can do for you, some of the different settings. And you could, of course, dig deeper into these. There's a lot more settings that we didn't cover today. But yeah, that's some of what you can do with this. So now let's look at how to implement this in the Scriptcase. So let's go back here to administration. And here we saw these before. This is our widget code and also a direct chat link. Now, if you see here, we have this set up in a login application. But first, just so we can get the basics of how this works, let's set this up in a blank application. And we're going to use a widget just like we have here. So to do that, we're going to need to copy this widget code. So let's go ahead and copy that. It gives us a button that makes it nice and convenient. Let's go to our Scriptcase development environment. So I'm in that e-learning sample system that Scriptcase gives us. And we're going to create a new blank application. So I'm going to click New Application and choose blank here. Name it. Click Create. And a blank application is really just a place to put some code. So it makes it very easy for this. We can just do some simple testing, throw this code in place, and see if it works, see how it works, so we can set it up in a more realistic scenario. So I'm going to copy that code, or paste it here. So I'm going to paste that code that we just copied. And if you look at this, this is JavaScript. And right here, this onExecute field here for the application is expecting PHP. But that's no problem. All we need to do is close the PHP section of the code with a question mark and a bracket. And that puts us in a mode where it's just going to output it to the browser. And the browser will interpret it as JavaScript because it'll see this line right here where it tells it it's a script. And then all we need to do is open up the PHP tags again. So any code after that will be executed as PHP. So down here at the bottom, we just open that up as a PHP block again. So now this should be set up. We can chat with this, because it gave us all of our code, and we don't really need to even worry about all this because it's all set up and generated by Talk for us. So let's go ahead and run this and see if it works. Okay, and we ran it and it put that widget right there on the screen, and it already has our message because it's seeing it's coming from the same source. So it's already seeing those messages that we sent before, and we could send another one like so. And that would send a new message to our admin console right here. And we can see, there it is. Okay, so that's the basics of how you do it. And in a login application, it's very similar. So let's open up the login application and see what I did there to make that work. I copied that same bit of code from the Talk API. And then I just went to the events in the onload event. So this is when the login form loads. And I just put it right in there. So as soon as it loads, it's going to insert this little widget. I close the PHP tags the same way. And then I open the PHP tag back up there. And that's how it works. So that's very simple. So that's really easy. You just set up a widget, just copy that code in, and it works. You might have also noticed here, let's go back to our settings here. You might have also noticed this direct chat link. So this is an even more simple way to do it. All we need to do is either make that a clickable link on our web page or give it an iframe of some sort to put in there. So we're going to do this with a dashboard application, which will give us an iframe that we can point to this chat window, and we'll have the chatting completely on their servers. We won't even have to worry about putting a widget on our web page. We just have to point an iframe to it. So let's go back to Scriptcase development environment. Click new application. And we're going to do a dashboard application. Name that application and let's click create on this. Okay, so now we need to add a widget. So it's got this widget here created. Let's click edit on this. And in the link, we just need to copy this direct chat link here and put it in right here. And we see a message here. It's not recognizing this because it's not an application we have in our system, but we are adding a URL so we can just ignore this message. So let's hit save on this. There's some things we could do to control the UI. We'll do that in a second, but for right now, we just want to worry about getting this thing on screen so we can get it set up after that. So it should be on screen. So let's go ahead and run this and see what it looks like. Okay. So here we have a chat window put in basically just an iframe. So these are floating divs put in an iframe. And if you don't know what an iframe is, it's just a little window that you can put on your website. It's an HTML object that points to another place. So it could point to another place on your server, or it could point to another server entirely. And this is pointing to the talk server, to a little chat widget that they have on their server, and it's just pointing directly there. And so we don't need to worry about it at all. And as you can see, it's already recognized that we're here and saying, hey, send a message if you need any help. So we could send a message, just a simple hi. And over here, there we go. We've got that new message coming in right here. That's over in this window. So this one, it's recognizing as a different one because it's coming from a different source. This time the direct chat URL. So this is our message that we just sent. Now we could control this to make it look a bit nicer. So as you can see, the user can drag this around on the screen a little bit if they want to move it around like so. But this is kind of wide. It's not very nice looking. So let's adjust this just a little bit. So let's go back here to our dashboard settings. And this is where that widget is. And let's make it a little bit taller and more narrow like that. And then let's click run on this and see what it looks like. There we go. So that looks a little bit more realistic and the user could move that around if they wanted. And so you could have some other widgets here on screen. So maybe they're doing something over here and you have support over here because maybe they would need support for whatever they were doing over here, some process or something. And so that would just be right there for them to get help on. And they could kind of chat with that person and that person could give them instructions and then they could just implement those instructions right here. So that's basically how to implement web chat inside of Scriptcase. It's incredibly simple, incredibly easy to use, and cheap. For anything we just did, it didn't cost any money. So you would just need support people to sit here and watch this and answer any messages here. But the actual technology doesn't cost any money unless you want to use those add-ons and remove, you know, this branding right here and so forth. So just to reiterate, we looked at how to do this in a blank application and a login application, and that's using a widget that's using a little bit of JavaScript that is put into our website. And then we also looked how to do it in a dashboard application that uses a direct chat URL. That's a direct URL put in an iframe or something to use directly on Talk's servers. So I hope this is helpful for you, and I'll see you in the next tutorial.